Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Hello. Hello, everyone. Very good evening once again. Debut cast, season 12.
Here we are.
Man, it's been... Actually, it hasn't been that long because Div 1 actually just ended like several weeks ago. So, well, Division 3, it's been about 2-3 months.
Mm-hmm. And tonight, we are going to have a Div 3 match, of course. We are going to be having the 6 Gents facing off against Signatured. The rosters, I mean, they've been swapping out the rosters pre-game. Based on the people that you currently see inside the server, do you recognize any names? And who do you think might be standing out tonight?
I'm going to be completely honest. There are only 3 people here on my friends list, and they're people that I don't really talk to.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't actually recognize, like, okay, Asuna is Dio, and as far as I'm aware, Dio previously played in Division 3, but was medic for the team Chaotic Z, who placed second, but previously was playing medic.
Mm-hmm.
Boo is one of my old MASH mentees from ages ago. I have not seen him play in the longest time.
Uh-huh.
That's honestly all I recognize here.
Yes, I've only got like one person on my friends list, and that's the only reason he's on my friends list, because I needed to get the rosters. So I have absolutely no idea who these people are. But fingers crossed, you know, that we actually they prove themselves tonight, because as we all know, Div 3, despite being the lowest bracket in AFC, technically is they're the new blood, the new life that will be injected into the competitive scene. So I'm looking forward. I mean, back in AFC 10, we had TMG and BRG. They were in Div 3, and then, you know, AFC 11, they moved out to Div 2, and TMG, you know, just performing extremely well. So, you know, hopefully we might see some up-and-comers tonight.
Hopefully. Div 3 always has a reputation for being a little bit messy, not as tight, not as coordinated, but yeah, I mean, it's always nice to see new people playing the game, especially this season. There's been a huge upswing in signups. 24 Div 3 teams, can you believe it? 24. I remember in like AFC 10, was it AFC 10? Yeah, we got 16 signups, we were like, wow, that's a lot.
Yeah, and then here we are with 24. Yeah, so that's a huge increase. Always nice to see that the community is alive and well. So we should be able to be starting momentarily. All I have to do is just give them the green light. So technically, we're good to go. Tonight, of course, we're going to be having two maps. CP Snake Water is going to be going first, followed by CP Badlands. And so we're just going to have to give the green light and wait to see what happens. I know you hate me asking this, but do you have any predictions?
Oh, come on. I'm going to just go off pure instinct. I'm going to say that 6 is probably going to win this 4-2.
Ooh, okay.
I was taking a look at the score lines. It seems that both of these teams are fairly even as compared to their... So Abomination Echoes and 6 Gents actually did go against each other, and the score was 4-2 and 2-0. And Signature went against Hulu and went 1-6 and 1-3. So, in my opinion, those are fairly similar score lines to look at. So, if we're going to say that these teams are evenly matched, I want to put 6 gents ahead of SNR, Signature. So, well, you know, these are all just predictions and conjecture. We don't actually know what's going to happen until the game gets set in motion.
Yep, so just going to have to wait. Just wait for them to ready up, and then we can start. I'm just gonna go through the rosters really quickly. They've shuffled it around a couple of times before we actually started. Turtle Kick's gonna be the medic for the side of 6 Gents. We've got Buh on the Devilman. D4 and Asuna are our two Sollies. Thermal and Crybaby are gonna be the two scouts for the side of Signatured. We're gonna have Caramel and Jetty. Those are going to be our two scouts. We're going to have ZYSF, Zyfs, however you want to pronounce his name. He's going to be the Solly. XD still means he's going to be the Solly as well. Yeah, ZY, definitely much easier. Haze is going to be the demo man, and of course, Hemstar is going to be the medic. So we're just going to wait for them to ready up. I think we got a couple of AFKs right now, but we should be starting momentarily. People, of course, those who are currently inside the Twitch chat, please toss out your predictions as well. It does look like we are going to be going live off the bat. We are going to be on a Shana server, so there's not going to be any setup time, no resets, nothing. We're going to go live off the bat. So this is, of course, the first cast of the Asia Fortress 12, the first cast at least covered by us. And yeah, it's going to be the 6 gents against Signature, and mid-fight, of course, going to be underway very shortly. But going to reach about pretty much the same time as the other demo man. They're going to start spamming down straight away. We're going to see the scouts, of course, grabbing that high ground. Caramel just jumping about, trying to toss out those scatter shots, trying to tickle down the demo man from the side of 6 gents. But yeah, it's just everyone's just tossing damage out at each other. We got Solis bouncing up top, and ZY gonna get rehealed up by his medic. Aggressive bombs coming in from AT. Still memes being Asuna, the first one to get taken down, despite the red players being relatively low in terms of health. Caramel down to the double digits. Aggressively going down, trying to get the pick down onto the medic and the devilman. And it does look like the 6 gents are gonna have to back out. They do lose two of their Solis, and just gonna set up some sticky traps and back out.
Both teams played a very passive mid just in the beginning, as usual with the first mids of the game, until I do believe Asuna, also known as Dio, went down on the right side that just couldn't get enough heals. SNR just playing that spam game a little bit better, and then Dio went down, and that triggered the aggressive soldier bounce from ZY and XD still memes. We're gonna see an Uber trade coming in here. Asuna's jumping all the way in, but he doesn't force the Uber in time. Now his medic has to run out. The Uber is significantly worse, and Turtle Kicks is going to get picked off here, along with two other fragging classes. You're going to have to back out here or see them lose last.
Oh yeah. So, the 6 gents, despite, trying to pop that Uber early, they're going to drop almost pretty much all their players. D4 just spawning in right now. Second point already captured. We've got a scout bouncing about on the point, trying to capture it for his team. The other scout coming in to assist. He is going to get destroyed. Jetty's going to be destroyed, but Caramel's on the point. Standing strong. The Solly's going to come in to finally defend his point. Devilman spawning in as well. Tossing out the stickies on the point, trying to deny that capture. It does look like the Signatured players are going to have to back out. The medic does make it out alive, holding on to that 45% Uber charge. I would say relatively equal with Turtle Kicks just building up his charge as well. 41% against 59. Fairly even, and they're just trying to gain some ground now. Moving out to the second point. Thermo going to be running about, trying to toss out those scatter shots, but not too effective. We've got the Solly up top. ZY just standing on the fence, tossing out those rockets. XD Stealth Meme is going to get picked off by Thermal though, and Caramel just running around on the point protecting his medic, and does look like it might be a bit of a stalemate right now.
Someone's
apparently
trying
not
the back caps. Meatball was at last watching the point the entire time, but the scout slipped through his fingers through the drop down, got onto the point and said, bye bye, we're going to take this round. I don't know, I think they could have pushed out a lot more aggressively since it was even Ubers, and they did seem to be on top of the things in terms of health, but you know, they just moved a little bit too slow and just ended up wasting time until the scout could leak behind and get a back cap.
Yep, so back cap goes down. Quite a sad way to go, but first point goes into the hands of Signature, and once again mid-fight, of course, gonna be underway. Massive air shot coming out from D4, tossing the Solly across the map, but he goes down instead. Asuna gonna be really low for the arrow, gonna be tossed in from the medic. Red player's gonna be hanging a little bit far back though. They're just trying to spam from a distance. Caramel jumping onto the shed and moving up to the upper levels, but it does look like the blue team, the six gents, they did gain a bit of ground, but now they're just backing out with the bombs coming in from ZY, taking down the medic, and Bar, of course, the demo man going down as well. The scout's gonna try to come in, but just getting absolutely destroyed. Only players up gonna be D4 as well as Asuna, and they're gonna have to back out. It might look like they're gonna have to toss the second point.
Yeah, I'm not liking what I see from D4 and Asuna right here. Like, the moment they're trying to aggress across the top, but they're not fully committing, and their team is also just holding passively behind them. So every time they jump in, they sort of just get baited by the enemy, who seems to be a lot better in holding the forward point. But I'm talking about this, Hemstar does get forced out. And their Uber is going to run out right before they can come into last. They do have a two-man add, so they might try and take this, but it's not... they're not feeling very confident considering how much spam is coming into that trope.
Yeah, so the 6 gents just hanging back on the point. They do slide your rep, but I think it's going to be fairly negligible. Hemstar going to try to build up that charge to give the scout right there. You see him whipping in and damaging himself. And yeah, they should be able to catch up no problem. He's just going to hang back on the second point. Fairly safe distance away from the blue team. The 6 gents still hanging on to that last point. They're going to have that full overcharge ready to go, but I don't think they're going to... use it through?
Yeah, definitely not. Yeah. I mean, look at that demo just in position to stop the push. They're trying to go in right here, but I'm not sure it's a good idea considering that they've already flashed two people and the medic is not fast yet. Astronaut going in, finally getting out the fast, but it's the same situation we were seeing about just one round ago. Both of them die and now the enemy team, blue team, is just left at last with no medic.
Yeah, so no more heals for the side of the six gents. We got Jetty already moving forward together with Solly. They're just standing on the point, stacking the point, and they grab another point onto the scoreboard. So that Uber pop, a little bit shaky.
Yeah, props to six gents making the effort to try and take the trade out. But I don't know, S Signature is just too good at kiting that Uber, and in the first place, they are popping the Ubers like a little bit too early, and Astronaut just doesn't seem to be able to put out the damage to make sure that the medic forces it out.
Yep, so mid-fight gonna be underway once again. Both of them are reach about the same time. Asuna gonna be jumping up top this time around, gonna try to spam down those rockets, gonna get that rocket straight into the face of the Demoman Haze, and he's just gonna start shooting the crate and the floor as well. And not much damage getting tossed out by Asuna right now. We've got another aggressive bomb coming in. The counter jumps coming in from Asuna. Can he land down onto the medic? Yes, he can, but he's going to get absolutely destroyed by the scout with that scatter shot. It's going to take him down. XD still memes, of course, going to go down as well. So two Solis going to get traded on the mid fight.
Oh, big bomb by default coming in. The rest of his team should be aggressing straight across the point right now. That scout is so hurt, he's going to create the... But I don't know, you look at the scout and the demo just dancing around the point, they don't need to be doing that. They should be pushing forward into the hurt players, all of the hurt players of Signature, but they choose not to, and the only people they're able to pick off are Haze and Caramel.
Yes.
They could have totally rolled that in the second.
Mm-hmm. So they're just going to hang back. Uber's of course going to be equal, and it does look like they're going to possibly pop in. Might be wrong. They do drop ZY, the medic really far away, not enough place to heal. Gonna have to force out that Uber charge. Good job coming up from Bar. He's gonna get taken down in the end, but they're gonna hold on to that full Uber charge, and the counter pop is gonna come in. Asuna gonna be shiny, has a sight down onto the medic, misses that air rocket. The medic still juking about, but eventually gonna be in, tossed into tiny pieces. We got a couple of scouts still running around behind them. Caramel as well as Jetty gonna rush that midpoint. Caramel just running back, trying to cause that distraction strat with Jetty just capping that midpoint. They're gonna have to run back and actually stop this to happen.
This is pretty questionable. The scout on the point stopping the backhand. I think he's gonna get stopped before he can cap it off entirely.
Yeah.
But you see that the slight add that Turtle Case was gonna have about a 30% add, but his soldiers were committing in different directions and his scouts both got, like, their flanks got raped on the grass side. So, like, in the end, what could have been a pretty solid push just turned into a series of DM fights in multiple locations instead of like a team fight. And you don't want that to happen because it just means that your players can get out DM and situations that you could potentially have used to get into last just ends up with you having to back out because your medic has no one to play around with.
Yep, so we've got both sides building it up and then we recharge fairly equal spread. Turtle Kicked, however, going to be pushing in together with his team. The scout's still getting a little bit damaged, but he's going to be fine. They're just slowly trying to inch forward, trying to gain the Saw Room, just spamming out the Signature's players. Demoman for the side of Signature, Hayes is still just trying to spam through as well. It's just another spam pheasant choke, and Asuna just eating that rocket, going to get taken down. The Solly turns around to look at his medic, and he decides to push in, but both medics still holding on to that Uber Charge. Aggressive bomb straight away. ZY has his eyes down on the medic, then drop! Ooh, Turtle Kicks plus twos in chat. Does look like they should be able to push in, but they're just taking their time right now. Aggressive bomb from the Solly, but he's gonna get absolutely denied!
Oh my god, what the heck just happened?
What?
Crybaby just ran in and fragged the medic without any repercussions whatsoever. He's still alive. I might get the soldier here as well.
No.
Dealing
way.
Off quite a bit. Oh my god. That's got a third ping in the trip for his life, but that was absolutely huge from Crybaby. Saw the opportunity, I think he ran in straight from kitchen into the medic and just two-shot him along with someone else. And now it's going to be, he did even out the Uber situation. Mm-hmm. It was a full disad, so great place from Crybaby. The rest of his team are gonna try and move in here and they might actually be able to take this point.
Yep, so D4 going to be jumping up top together with his Solly friend. Jetty is going to be right there jumping up as well, trying to get some picks off. But it does look like the Signature players are just going to be backing out to the second point with the six gents. with a pretty dominating presence on mid. Ubers, of course, going to be relatively equal, and they're just going to be pushing forward once again. So definitely Crybaby, player of the game so far, taking down that medic, negating that Uber charge. And ooh, the red players are just getting damaged, though. They're just taking so much damage, looking at the health bars. And they're all pretty low compared to the blue players.
I can tell that blue team's pocket classes just really like to spam, especially you could see just now. Asuna was the one that triggered the push going down during that saw spam session. So I mean, it's nice to be able to play aggressively, like, but when your whole team is, well, like, when you do go down for it, you just need to be able to measure yourself to make sure that you don't take that much damage. See, it's just like a DM thing. You have to know what your limits are. And right now, there's actually a very aggressive bomb coming in from default. No one was watching the grass side. He does get two picks, including the medic, and he's gonna be able to get another pick here if he plays this grass side. Unfortunately, he goes down. But he did what he needed to do. That was a great bomb from him. Although the rest of his team does seem to be failing very poorly here.
Yeah, but they do still somewhat successfully push forward. We got the Solly going up against each other. It does look like they're going to be able to grab this second point. So, good job coming out from the six gents with that bomb coming out from D4, taking down the medic. And that drop definitely going to allow them to push forward. They've got to play the heal game right now. Turtle Kick's going to have that full Ubercharge as well. They're just going to be standing on the left side. Don't know why they're not just pushing in with that Uber charge?
Asuna's calling for his medic. Pop the Uber. Finally goes in, but he's not putting out enough damage. That heavy is just so tanky. Walking around, finally gets taken down, but all he's done with the Uber is kill one heavy. Although the rest of his team is coming in here and picking up a ton of frags, piling onto the point. The devil can do nothing about the situation. And the first point for six gents.
Oh yeah, finally they just tossed that point onto the scoreboard. Six gents gonna grab a score. We've got 18 minutes and 23 seconds in the server clock counting down. Lots of stuff can still happen. Current score 2-1 in favor of the Signatured. And mid fight, of course, gonna go underway once again. Both demo men reach at approximately the same time, with Haze eating the first pipe. We're gonna have the scouts up top, Jetty just jumping about, and Caramel, of course, gonna be on the shed with the players from the six gents this time trying to gain that high ground first. We've got a Solly fights going up top, MGE style. First one to go down is gonna be D4 Asuna. Possibly gonna follow shortly after, dies to the laws of gravity. Burr gonna be healed up by the medic, gonna try to toss out those stinkies, but it doesn't look like they're gonna have to back out. A little bit of lag coming up from Burr, he's gonna get finished off by XD Steel Memes, and that is pretty much midpoint and possibly second point gone for the six gents.
Yeah, I don't think they're gonna be able to, like, they could if they really wanted to, but it would be a very risky play. They're not gonna contest here. I don't know, so far from what I've seen, Signature just really has a better handle of mids than their opponents. Mm-hmm. So every time the soldiers from D4 and Arsenal try to commit across the point, they just get out spammed by the enemy. So maybe something along the lines of the scouts just being in better positions to deny six gen soldiers. Something along those lines is just making mids not work out for six gens.
D4 lands a very meaty 150 damage shot down. It's interesting to see that they choose to offclass the Solly instead. But he's going to change back to the Solly once again. So, sniper plays, that's pretty much it for now. Thermo going to be taken down in the spam fest.
Yeah, I just like to mention that Hamstar actually had balls of steel. He was taken down to 20 health, and he was holding in a position where the soldier could have walked in and just dropped him, but he held that Uber even though his pocket was like 30 health as well.
Plays. Balls of steel, Hamstar. So just once again, just gonna be a little bit of a spam fest through choke. Burr, of course, gonna eat the majority of that spam. But both teams not too keen on pushing in or out. Asuna gonna be standing on the fence right now. Does look like everyone's just backing out for the side of Signature. They're just not too keen on hanging up close. They do get the force down though. XD still means goes flying in, getting the force down onto Turtle Kicks. They're gonna try to make the most of this. Aggressive bomb straight down onto Hamstar, but he's gonna eventually pop his as well. Not too sure if they're gonna be able to capitalize on this, but Caramel's gonna be going in all shiny. They've got a heavy weapons guy in place. Tiki's on the point, gonna destroy Caramel off the bat. Hamstar goes down as well, so no heals, and a huge Uber ad for the side of six gents, unless ZY can do something about it. But the heavy weapons guy probably gonna make short work of the Solly. There we go, he's gonna get taken down. Bit of a shame, despite having that pretty sizable Uber ad, they come in and practically nothing was done.
Yeah, it was actually a pretty good play by Arsenal to kind of force out the Uber a little bit earlier than the Signature definitely would have liked. And he did get out and distract the scout for quite a period of time, so, you know, he did slow down the push quite a lot, and that was all the blue team needed to be able to defend that last point.
Yep, so the 6 gents are going to be able to re-grab that second point. We've got the signatured people trying to build up that he would charge as well. But full Uber for the side of the 6 gents. Signature people might want to hang a little bit further back. They're just spamming through choke, and I don't know why the 6 gents aren't flying in. They've got that Uber charge, and it's not going to have any ad anytime soon.
Yeah, they're pretty slow on pushes so far. I mean, most of the time they're either getting dropped off, like forcing out in bad positions. Yeah. They just lost a significant ad, and all they've got to show for it is one pick so far.
Yeah, and it's not going to be of any use right now. Both medics do pop that Uber charge. Turtle King's going to be a little bit low. He's going to back out all the way really quickly away from his teammates. Crybaby going to go down, but Hemstar going to be really low as well. Going to be taken down by splash damage, and they're just doing cleanup this time around. These signature players are going to get picked off one by one, and midpoint possibly going to go into the hands of the 6 gents. Probably going to go into the hands of the 6 gents.
Yeah, I think Signature didn't back out fast enough, and they didn't really expect to lose that DM fight considering that they are a soldier and a medic. But Asuna playing in that kitchen area was just in a great position. He took out the medic and did a ton of damage to the soldier, and then the rest of 6 gents were able to come back in and clean up everything else and giving them that mid. They do have a slight advantage now, but based on what I've been seeing from 6 gents so far, I'm not sure they're gonna make anything of it. So
yeah, they're just probably gonna hold on to it, get equal Uber, and then push in on equal Ubers. But I don't know. We're just gonna have to see how things play out. Once again, it's just gonna be a little bit of stalemate at the sword room. Once again, everyone's just gonna be spamming at each other, trying to get lucky picks through the spam. But as of right now, everyone's at a fairly safe distance away. We can see some sticky traps in play. Asuna just walking in blindly, eating the full brunt of that sticky trap.
He did that again. Like, that's not the first time he's done that. Like I say, you need to know your limits and you need to know your traps. Like, you have to spam the corners before you go in and try to put out a bit of damage. They are coming in here. Default does get the force, but it might be at the cost of his life. And with 2 soldiers down during the push, this isn't a great position for Turtle Kicks. He's gonna...
Oh.
What?
What?
What just he just not use?
Yeah,
that was pretty bad. That was like he had to use that. He could see the damage coming from him, but maybe his right click was broken or something. But that's gonna put 6 gents in a terrible position. 40% and 30% at and counting with now. The entirety of red team could just grind out
D4!
Oh gosh, D4 coming in, and unfortunately not being able to pick up the medic would have been a great play for his team. But it isn't the end of the game. He's gonna spawn in 12 seconds. He can, like, all blue team has to do here is just properly kite the Uber and re-push afterwards with the Uber charge that they will definitely get once Signature's Uber has faded.
Yep, so we're gonna have the off classes coming in. We've got an engineer trying to get the 7th man up. We've got a heavy weapons guy on the point. And Uber out, of course, very sizable into the hands of Hemstar, currently 90%. I really have no idea what Turtle Kicks was doing earlier on, but they're gonna have to start defending their final point right now. Burr's just gonna be picking through, trying to spam through the lobby. We've got Solis tossing out rockets from below as well. And ZY and XD Stale Memes just peeking around the lower lobby. Medic, of course, still holding on to their full Uber charge. Not anymore. It's no more ad. They've got their sights down onto Turtle Kicks. They pop their Uber charge. First priority is going to be the sentry gun. They make short work of it. And Burr's going to be dropped by his medic Uber. Focus down onto Asuna. Everyone else is going to be dropping really low thermal. Burr, D4, Turtle Kicks falling down next.
Oh my god, that was...
Ooh, it was a massacre.
Yeah, Signature pushed in and played aggressively against the demo. And I don't think that Turtle Kicks knew that he had to pop, like... Well, could comprehend that he had to pop there because it still looked like a winning situation for his team, but he popped so late and focused it all onto the soldier that the rest of his players were just dying around him.
Yeah, so he's just dropped pretty much half of his team, and they just did the cleanup after the Uber's faded. And mid fight, of course, gonna go underway once again. Gonna have these 6 gents taking so much damage during the mid fight. Asuna getting taken out to the double digits. Thermal getting taken out really low. Asuna getting finished off. We got aggressive bombs coming from D4. It does look like they are gonna be able to pick up a couple of players. They do pick up the medic, the demo, the soli, the scout following shortly after. But the medic for the side of 6 gents gonna be at 74 health. He's gonna be fine. Only person up gonna be
excellent.
ZY. And full wipe on the midpoint for 6 Gents, very well played.
That's exactly what I want to see from 6 Gents. They knew that they weren't playing aggressively enough, so they sent in a soldier and another soldier, one after another, and then pushed the rest of their team straight across the point. That is what they need to win the mid. They need more aggression. Like, if they know that they're going to lose the spam game, they have to just commit, and that's what they did, and they managed to wipe the entire enemy team.
Yeah, they're going to be able to grab the second point as well. They've got that full Ubercharge too, so if it's any time to push in, it is technically right now. Once again, I do believe Asuna is going to be the favorite Solly, shiny Solly of choice. And they should move in any time now. There we go, going to pop that Ubercharge, going to jump straight in. He has to focus down that medic who wants to get anything done, but his rockets are just not doing anything at all. Haven't even picked up a person, finally picking up Haze the moment the Uber ends. Heavy's still up and well, so healthy, so juicy on the point, finally getting finished off. Aggressive bomb coming in from the other Solly, going to pick up ZY, and Therma going to be falling shortly after. Hemstar finally getting taken down. So much DM getting tossed about on that final point. We've got the only scout on the front line.
Still up.
Wow,
D-Boy just can't land the rockets. He's just standing there trying to spam out the sentry, but his rockets just keep hitting the wrong position. That is a DM error right there. And now he's in a position where he can't do anything. The rest of Signature is just respawning. All they did was equalize the situation. Oh my god, that DM fight by the truck just didn't seem to be working out for either team.
Nothing was landing, everyone was missing all their shots, and that was just a huge mess. Aggressive bomb coming from Asuna though, can he pick up the demo man? No, he can't, he's gonna get finished off by those stickies. Crybaby going down as well.
What?
And the 6 Gents, man, they're gonna have to start backing out. I don't think they can do anything about this second point. The Signature, man, they're just gonna re-grab it and continue pushing strong to the next point. They have 3 people down right now. I don't think they're gonna be able to defend this midpoint. And the Signature players are just slowly gonna be inching their way forward.
They should not be inching here. Their soldiers should be jumping straight in, aggressively taking all that space. But they're just standing there, spamming passively, even though they had such a great advantage to push. Unfortunately, these are some of the mistakes that the players are just going to keep making if they don't realize how aggressive they can be. I mean, Signature has all the momentum here, so I guess they do have the right to stalemate if they want to, but that was the perfect opportunity.
Ooh, the Uber gets forced by D4, jumping around inside the kitchen, going to get a force down. That is going to be huge for the size of the 6 Gents. Uber eventually going to get popped by Turtle Case. They're going to try to do something with this. Trying to focus down that medic, but the rocket's finally finding its mark. Gonna have a bottle coming in, but he is still shiny. He's gonna be fine. And everyone's just gonna start collapsing down onto the 6 Gents. Not gonna matter anymore with the only person I'm being Jetty. And full wipe coming out. 6 Gents once again. They do drop the medic though, so that is not looking up so far.
Control point is being contested. It won't, in the long run, I don't think it'll matter a whole lot. Turtle Kicks is spawning just about the same time as Hamstar. This is not a great enough Uber for them to grind out, although Turtle Kicks didn't take forward, so he might have a greater amount of this ad than I thought he was gonna have. But still, the onus really is on 6 Gents to push here. They are the ones that are 2 points down, so they're gonna have to figure out something here. I don't think Signature is gonna try and make a push out of last, considering that they'll think their ad isn't as great as it currently is. Mm-hmm. So, it's going to be on 6 Gents. You see what they can do so far. D4 has been able to put up some great bombs into the enemy team, but if he keeps doing the same thing, he's going to eventually end up pretty predictable.
Yeah. So it's just going to be a little bit of a stalemate. Hempstar going to get that Ubercharge ready to go first. But as you said, I don't think they're gonna do anything with this. They're just gonna hang back, defend their final point. They've got 6 minutes, 42 seconds counting down. They're 2 points up. And it's up to the 6 Gents if they want to do anything. They have to push forward if they want to get some points on the scoreboard. The timer, of course, is still ticking out. There's still time for them to make a comeback. But at the rate things are going, if they're not being aggressive enough, it's just not going to be looking up. So both medics do have that Ubercharge ready to go, just spamming through that lobby side. And medics slowly making their way to the front line. Is going to link up with Asuna once again, the shiny Solly of choice. And there we go, I do believe Uber's going to be popped instantly. They're trying to get the force down, if not pick off other players who are not shiny. And there we go, the counter Uber is going to get popped immediately. ZY going to be shiny, going to focus down that Solly. We've got medic jumping about on the point. The Duke's Turtle Kick somehow still alive. They're just running blindly on the point though, a little bit desperate right there. The scout's coming in. Can they do the cleanup though? We've got Demoman standing on the point. Can he pick up the Solly? Yes, he can.
Oh, that was actually that was actually admirably played by Six Gents.
Yeah.
What they did instead of going straight for the medic like normal teams would is that they focused other targets instead. And once the enemy team had popped off their Uber and sent the enemy, like one signature had popped off their Uber and sent themselves straight chasing for all the other frags, the scouts from Signature Thermal and Crybaby just ran in and destroyed the main target that would contest them for the point, which was the demo. And then it was just the rest is history, you know, all of them just rotating around the point, getting the DM frags that they needed to be able to secure the point.
Yep, and there's a pause going down right now. Current score is 2-3 in favor of Signature. We are going to be going on the next round soon. 5 minutes and 38 seconds counting down on the server clock. And lots of time for some comeback action from the Six Gents. They did a really good push on the final point earlier on. And yeah, just gonna have to wait for the unpause to come down before we can see the conclusion of what's to come. So, so far, I still think that the player of the game for me is still Cry picking up the medic when he just came in and just two-shotted.
Yeah, that was actually pretty insane. I did not expect him to run in and get anything.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't even know that he was positioned in kitchen, but he just ran in and
just popped out,
fragged the medic. It was the, it's like, you know that situation where you're like, oh, we drop the medic, we're gonna win, and then suddenly your medic gets dropped.
Yeah.
And you're like, what the hell? What just happened?
Yeah, it's just amazing plays all around. And mid fight, of course, gonna be underway. The unpause has come into play, and we are gonna start the game once again. Everyone's gonna be jumping about, spamming out those stickies, those rockets, those scatter shots, aggressive bombs coming up from both sides. Gonna eat quite a lot of damage, and still Meme's gonna be the first one taken out. D4 once again with the aggressive bomb, trying to pick up the medic, but he's gonna get punished for that jump. Asuna gonna try to follow up with the damage, but Hemstar just running about, juking all that damage, still alive, eventually gonna get picked off by the sticky getting tossed across the map from Ba, and Turtle Kid's gonna die to Jetty
nice
as well.
Nice shots by Jetty, oh man.
The cleanup though, Six Gents currently only two people at the front lines, and the scouts just running about wreaking havoc. They're gonna do the cleanup for the team, and they are gonna be able to rush back in, recapture this midpoint, but there's quite a lot of capture time, so this is gonna buy a little bit of time for the Six Gents to reorganize themselves on the second point. Both medics did get taken down during the mid fight, and Hemstar hasn't started building that charge despite spawning first. Slowly walking his way to the front lines with no escort service coming from the scouts. We've got Turtle Kids at 24% compared to Hamstar's 5, but they're just gonna start building up that charge as well. But at the rate things are going, I do think Turtle Kids should be able to get that charge first. Appears I may be wrong though, with Hamstar building up really fast as well. But second point still in the hands of the Six Gents, with signature players just waiting for that push.
Yeah, that I want to talk about that mid. It kind of felt like Default was getting baited by the rest of his team, because you could see that Asuna was a little bit hurt, but that didn't. So he was standing still for the medic to get an arrow. But in that sort of situation, when your entire one of your teammates is committing and the rest of them are trying to get support, you should probably, instead of just waiting, just go forward with your medic, tank the heals, and jump in to fully commit, because I could see that that was kind of a turning point for the push, where D4 was in and the rest of Signature was backed up. If another soldier had gone in right there, Signature would have just exploded, but unfortunately that's not what happened.
Yep, so both medics are gonna have that Uber charge ready to go. Does look like they want to pop onto ZY. Yeah, they're just inching forward. Asuna, of course, gonna be right there eating the brunt of the spam, and yeah. Thankfully, Turtle Kicks didn't pop that Uber charge, because that would have been a little bit messy if they popped so early on. But yeah, once again, it's just gonna, everyone's gonna reset once again and just start spamming each other down. It does look like XD and the other scout are gonna be watching the flank side, just spamming rockets through, trying to toss out some damage, which is relatively successful with Turtle Kicks eating quite a bit of spam. But they are finally gonna be pushed back by the other Soli coming in. So it's, everyone's just hanging tight, not too keen on pushing out on that Uber charge. What I want to see is someone get a sack in, try to get that force, but looks like we're gonna have to be content with first spamfest.
I don't want to jinx anything, but it's already 2 minutes and 32 seconds, and Six Gents are currently being held on their second. It's fully possible to roll all the way in about 45 seconds from here, but the way things are slowly grinding out, Six Gents have to make a move right now if they really want to get anything done, because that time is just against them.
Yep, so they really need to grab another round, possibly tie this game, and push it into the next map, calling this game a tie. And that's all they're eventually going to start pushing out. They got their full Uber charge ready to go. D4 going to be tossed all the way across the map behind them. And they're just going to start dropping their players. D4 eventually going to try and focus down the demo man, but the scout going to come in and try and finish him off as well. Jetty going to get picked off instead, but D4 is going to get taken down thanks to Hay Stickies. And it does look like Signature are going to be pushing forward to capture this second point. They don't have the demo man, they don't have their Solly, and they're just gonna be stuck on that final point. No off classing right now, though, no heavy weapons guy or whatever to contest it. But they're just gonna be hanging tight. A minute and 27 to push to last, gonna be really tight for the six gents.
Yeah, you know, I said that they needed to push, and they did, but unfortunately, Phil. And that's just the thing that, like, TF2 is about. Sometimes you just have to take risks to turn the games around. And right now, six gents are just not feeling it. They're getting taken out one by one. Signature is just on a rush. 1 minute left. How can they possibly lose? They're just coming in. And this might just seal the deal for six gents and push them into trash time.
That's possibly pretty much it. We've got Hayes and the scout just dancing on the point. Finally gonna get picked off. The medic coming in though! The medic with the Ubersaw, but it doesn't really matter anymore. Valiant attempt. 4-2. It's pretty much going to be the first map into the hands of Signature.
You know, I just like to say that I have a serious case of costless curse, because I called that 6 gents was going to win 4-2, and look at the scoreline.
Yeah, it's flipped around 4-2 in favor of Signature. But of course, this is just the first map. Everyone's just gonna start farming those slogs right now, just spamming out onto the point, trying to get that damage up. And 15 seconds counting down is pretty much it. 4-2 in favor of Signature. That's gonna be the first map. And first map in the favor of Signature, 4-2. And we will be moving on to CP Badlands next. 3 seconds counting down, and then we can see the logs to see who is gonna be the top performer for the first map.
It was a pretty even game. I wouldn't say that anyone was particularly outstanding. They each playing their own role. But DYSF definitely does seem to be a lot more on top of things when it comes to spam and aggression. Asuna, based on what I can see, Asuna as a pocket for 6 gents. He is trying to play super aggressively, but almost excessively so. And at some moments, it just ends up putting his team in really bad positions. So might just want to figure things out within the team there.
So we've got the logs on screen right now. Top damage, of course, going to be ZYSF with a whopping 12,000 damage, 396 damage per minute. And the second place position is going to be Asuna at 9,700, followed by Hayes at 7,600. So the two Solis is going to be up top, taking the two top ranks for the top damages. Top fragger, of course, going to be ZYSF once again, 27 kills. And with the highest KD is going to be Jetty at 2.2 with ZY at 2.1. So those two players are going to be up top in terms of damage as well as fragging. We're going to have two drops coming up from both sides, Hamster as well as Turtle Kicks. Heal spread going to be pretty about the same, I would say. Just the Scout and the Solly interchange in between. And fairly even spread. Both medics do drop twice, a bit of a shame. Top damage, of course, going to be ZY for this first map.
Yeah, at this point, it's just hard to say, like, who is the burden. But if you take a look at the scouts on the side of 6 gents, they're definitely not really putting out enough damage, considering the fact that, like, you know, one of them is taking 23% heals.
Yeah.
So, you know, as a scout in lower division, like, scout is a class where at the lower divisions, it's really difficult to play. Well, no, it's pretty easy to do well, but unfortunately, it's also like, I don't want to say, it gets harder as the divisions get higher.
Yeah.
But it also gets more exponentially more powerful. So what I'm thinking right here is that Thermal and Crybaby just cannot, they're just not able to handle ZYSF, who does seem to be sort of out DMing the rest of the, like everyone else on the server.
Mm-hmm.
So they have to figure things out, you know. Honestly, I want to say that D4 was actually, like, despite the stats, was actually doing pretty well for his team. He was really, like, trying, like, with the amount of heals he was given, he was trying to open things up, getting in, like, frags onto the medic. I do believe he only had one medic frag, though. So it's just a lot about trying to make space for the rest of his team. And unfortunately, the way the rest of his team was performing, I guess making space for them wasn't really the greatest thing he could be doing. But yeah, hopefully we can see some changes in the second map.
Yep, hopefully we're gonna see some, see the six gents pull forward on CP Badlands, which is of course the second map for tonight. For those of you who are just joining us once again, welcome and good evening to the AsiaFortress Cup Season 12! Tonight we are gonna have the Div 3 teams, the six gents, facing off against Signatured. The first map has been played, CP Snakewater has gone into the favour of Signatured 4-2. We will be moving on to the next map, CP Badlands. So we're just waiting on the teams to sort everything out and change the map.
Yep, they're just DMing here, I'm not sure why it's taking so long.
Yeah.
Should I, as an administrator, execute the conflict?
Sure, you can do it for them. Yep, so we've got a little game going on once again for all you people inside Twitch chat to bet and see who's gonna take CP Badlands, just to have some fun while we wait for things to be sorted out and for the match to start, of course. You guys got, at the looks of it, 3 minutes and 2 seconds counting down before the polls close, and we are currently seeing 75% people voting for Signature to take this map as well, with the six gents only at 25%. But yeah, we're just gonna have to wait and see. We are just gonna be moving on into the next map with all the players slowly coming in. And just hang tight for now. In terms of predictions, we've got those coming in from the Twitch chat people as well. Casters predictions, I think let's keep off that for now. Just stray away from that from now, because every time we toss out predictions, we always either get it wrong or it gets horribly swung into the other direction. But we're gonna have to see how things play out. This, of course, CP Badlands, a very common map played. Everyone knows this map, and
almost everyone hates it, apparently.
Yeah, it's probably one of, if not the oldest map that has been played constantly throughout every league and every pug or scrim and pretty much everything. So just gonna have to see how the teams play on this map. Just just waiting for everyone to come in. It does look like everyone's already in, so yeah, let's just see.
They're gonna be talking strats right now, hopefully sorting out issues, though. This point in time, it's difficult to say whether, I don't want to be a pessimist, but in Div 3, it's very easy to say, oh, we are being out DM, there's just literally nothing we can do. And I don't want to be the negative Nancy, but DYSF really does seem to be above the others in terms of, like, in the competition. So if he's going to perform the same way he did last map, there's very little that Six Gents can do to stop him unless their scout starts really stepping it up. Because the especially on a map like Badlands Mid, where soldier aggression is everything.
Yeah.
If the scouts can't halt that, like, if Thermal and Crybaby can't find a way to stop ZYSF and, XD Steel Means from dominating them at mids, then it's gonna be just, Six Gents losing every single mid and not being able to find a way to push back into it.
I don't know, we're just gonna have to wait and see once everyone is readied up. So just gonna give them the green light once again, maybe they're just waiting for that. But yeah, we are gonna be on the second map tonight, CP Badlands. I'm looking forward to actually see if the Six Gents can turn things around.
I'm actually curious if anyone knows who are the main contenders for the Division 3 championship title this season, because honestly, like, when I saw that there were 24 teams, I just died inside, and I was just like, I'm not even gonna bother, like, trying to predict who's gonna come out on top 4.
Yeah, it's gonna be really tough to decide and to really see which team is gonna come out on top. I guess, I don't know. I haven't even gone through the entire team rosters for the team directory for Div 3, so I'm just gonna do a quick scroll through right now to see who they are. We've got people, we've got familiar names, we've seen some people. We've got Nuku in some teams, we've got Eganox, names we've seen before, Crystal, Akshay, Eclipse, yeah.
They're well-known names, but they're not like carries. You know. And as well as the fact that I think this season they've been distributed like fairly evenly enough, like especially like some inside talk, you know, the division admins were saying that this season it was very difficult to bump up people because everyone seemed to be working, like everyone seemed to be signing up for the correct division that we usually perceive them to be in. So it was just like, okay, we'll leave things as they are. As you see, like this season no one got moved up and no one got like transferred out of the division. So hopefully we'll have a clean season this time around, because last season did have some strange drama.
Yeah, there was some, I don't know, people were just sounding out about, you know, not being in the right division or whatever. But this season, I mean, you know, just based on the previous match alone, they're generally, you know, 4-2, it wasn't really a roll to say. It was fairly even. There were push-pulls here and there. Good drops and good picks coming up from both sides, so I would say, yeah, they're pretty much where they should be, I guess, in terms of the ranked play, the respective divisions. So this season is probably going to be pretty interesting. We're not going to see any straight-on rolls, at least not yet, though. But so far, so good.
We'll wait till we get that. Like, this is a particularly good game because both teams are, so far from what I've seen, on even standing with each other.
Mm-hmm.
So like I said, the edge for Signature really seems to be ZYSF or Ziff, as he told us how it was.
Okay.
But we'll see if they can pull out something together.
Right, so just gonna be waiting on them to ready up. Not too sure what they're waiting for though.
They say that one of their players are in the toilet. So, right. The Call of Nature is currently holding one of them prisoner.
Indeed. The Call of Nature going to be holding, let's see who's AFK. Scroll through all the players. And none of them are AFK, so someone's lying. Someone's lying right now.
I was not lying, I'm just repeating what they were saying.
Yeah, some team is lying right now. But yeah, we should be... oh, there we go, Crybaby's not moving.
I'm
right
getting
now.
Called out in chat right now. Moose mentioning that Kratos' team did actually get moved up to Div 2. I kind of forgot about that, but I do feel guilty now. He is currently my lord and savior. I will not air dirty laundry in
oh, snap. The car. Yeah, so yeah, we got one team that Kratos team pushed up to Div 2.
And the Aussies, yeah, as well. Got
oh yeah, the Aussies, right. So, you get a couple people, you get shifted about, but it's fine. Pushed about to their respective divisions where they will be able to play on more equal ground, which is of course more, it's basically fair play to the people in those divisions that, you know, they're supposed to be in. Can't have a crazy team coming in just rolling them down, and doesn't look like we are going to be going live! So this is going to be the second map for tonight. Server clock are going to start ticking down. CP Batlands, here we go. And rollout's going to be start coming in. We've got Bar, going to bump his head a little bit. He's going to be fine, slowly making his rollout. I do believe they should be able to make their way to the mid fairly even. Spamfest gonna start straight away. Bug gonna eat that sticky straight off the bat. Aggressive bomb coming in from Asuna straight down. Hemstar gonna be the first one to get picked off during the mid fight. That's not looking up for SNR so far, and they're gonna need to try and counter that pick, and there you go, they do so successfully. XD still memes gonna be flying across the map picking up turtle kicks, but midpoint still gonna be in the hands of the six gents. However, the Ubers have been pretty much equaled, if not tossed into slight advantage in the hands of Hemstar, just waiting for him to start building, which is apparently not happening. There we go. So midpoint should be in the
hands. It's being contested right now by both scouts from the side of Signature. Signature actually just decided to come back in with their DMN and pick up everyone that was trying to cap the point, which is really strange. I wouldn't think that it would work, but apparently it did work out for them. They didn't stop the point, but they got a few picks that might signal the push from Signature to come back in here. Although now they're just dancing about, playing footsie with each other, deciding whether or not to go in, and in the process, Total Kicks gets picked off, which is not great for six gents.
Yep, so it's midpoint still up for grabs. No one's capped the midpoint yet. We still got a little bit of... Blue has capped the midpoint, my bad. But they are going to drop their medic once again. He's going to be down. That's going to toss a very nice sizable Uber rat into the hands of Hempstar. Ziff going to be jumping back in once again. Can't crouch jump onto the crates. Eventually going to do so successfully. Going to be standing on that point for his team. And yeah, they're going to try to come in and contest it once again with the scouts.
Okay, just saying two minutes in and I have no idea what the hell is even happening. Like, this is... Like, everyone's just deciding when they want to run in. Hillbilly just going back and forth.
Yeah.
Like, now there's a soldier fighting at mid and ZYSF has to run away, but the entirety of 6 Gents is still not into the mid side, even though one of their players was back. I don't know. It's just so messy right now. I think both teams don't have a handle on what's really going on, and they're just kind of DMing their way to victory.
Yeah, so really messy. Asuna not landing under the rockets. The Solly's still alive, gonna take Asuna down once again. XD still memes, eventually gonna get finished off by D4 coming in with that rocket launcher. We got scouts tossing the scatter shots, but midpoint still in the hands of Signature. But as you said, it's really messy with everyone just flying in. And
6 Gents are going to make the push here, definitely. Yep, they're popping the scout in, which is a pretty good move, but the scout has to be landing some shots, and someone else has to come in with the Uber in order for anything to be achieved. They have not done anything. Thermal just missing all his shots and almost getting picked off in the process. Hempstar already at 82%, and in the process, Jetty picking off Turtle Kick, somehow managing to get behind. This is such a terrible push from 6 Gents.
Yeah, they're gonna be able to capture this point though, but you know, SNR, they're gonna be pushing back in. Burr gonna finish off himself with Haze picking off Thermal after that. The only people up at the front line is gonna be Asuna as well as Crybaby. And as of right now, it's gonna be a bit of a mess. D4's gonna off pass to Sniper once again. Not too sure if he's gonna get any picks at all, not too sure.
Hempstar dies! Hempstar drops the Uber! What is happening? Where are these people coming from? Like, it appears as though everyone has been equipped with teleporters. Somehow they just keep ending up behind each other and picking off. And now Turtle Kicks has the advantage. The advantages have just been going back and forth. Now, six Gents could actually try to peek more aggressively here if they wish to. Although they do have a sniper, so I don't think that's going to be happening. They're just probably going to wait until he gets a pick and then push off of that.
Mm-hmm. So... I mean, it was really a mess. I have no idea who to keep the camera on. And SNR just hanging on to that midpoint. We've got D4 still on the sniper roll, trying to get a pick before they decide to do anything at all. Uber got to be ready for the sight of the 6 Gents soon. Almost gets the shot down onto the demo man, but he doesn't land that headshot. Tries to get a meaty 150 shot, he does so. But the medic going to heal him back up once again. Turtle Kick somehow eating damage.
Yeah, they should be pushing here. Yeah, they're trying to go through a house. He's 100. I think the decision is just to try and push straight through. Although time is running out, they're just hesitating so much. And Hempstar is already on 87%. Asuna getting dropped in the process. I'm not sure how that happened. But now the Uber situation has just equalized and they're back to stalemating.
Turtle just dropped his Solly. Asuna tried to jump in. No Uber pop though. No flash, nothing. Now they pop the Uber with SNR with a full charge. They're going to pop their counter Uber as well, but they are going to be able to pick up XD Stale Memes. They do have a bit of ground on the midpoint. They are going to be stacking it right now. But we've got people capturing Spire. I don't think they're going to be able to cap it in time. It's time to run back. They're a little bit out of place. The medic going to be caught out. Hempstar is not in a happy place. Going to get picked off, and that is really just bad placement coming out from SNR.
Yeah, I feel like both teams are a little bit confused right now as to what's happening. Right now, this medic is abandoning his scout, who's trying to take the DM fight, and the rest of his team is just going to be surrounded by players spawning through that resub drop-down area. And now, again, the tides have turned, and Signature is going to be recapturing that mid. But D4 is hiding in that shack house site, so
yeah,
maybe he'll be able to turn things around for his team.
Waiting for Hemsa to reach the front lines before he starts his assault. I do believe he is ready to move right now. He knows where the medic is. He's gonna start his rocket jumping spree. He's gonna be jumping forward. Has his sights down onto Hempstar. Doesn't land that air shot.
Ooh,
he's not landing any rockets. He's gonna get punished by Caramel.
That was a great surf by Hempstar. Just whizzed his way through the air out of D4's rockets. but pretty inconsequential considering ZYSF had gone down recently as well. The ad is in the hand of Turtle Kicks, but again, based on what we're seeing from Six Gents, even if they do have advantage, they're just not going to push off of it because, you know, they're so slow and hesitant. Like 20% is really enough to try and work a pick with a soldier, like maybe even force a bad Uber out of the team. As I'm saying that, Thermal gets picked off on the flank side, almost got into that resub, but Jetty pursuing relentlessly and finally takes him down. Again, Ubers have equalized and both sides have lost the player.
Yep, so
Asuna dropping a nice try in chat. Oh.
So it's just gonna be a spam through choke. They've got both sides, but they do be charged. D4 gonna jump in, get that force down. Turtoku's yet to pop his Ubi charge. But they're backing out. No, there we go. Finally gonna pop that Ubi charge. I don't know why Bird jumped all the way far back onto the battlements, leaving the medic at the front lines together with the Solly. They do pick up Caramel, but they're gonna be caught out in quite a bit of a dangerous place. Turtoku's does make it out alive, but they're going to be losing so much ground. Thermo going to be jumping forward at 22 health, trying to get some picks, but it does look like they do successfully regain their ground.
That was actually great from Thermo, who came in at the last second and put a ton of damage to the medic, and that just made the entirety of Signature just play so passively. They decided that even though they might have won if they pushed, they just weren't going to go in anymore. So he did save the push for Six Gents, who are going to be holding at this choke again. Although I should mention that Hemstar does have Uber, while Turtle Kicks is only sitting at a 70%. So if Signature play their cards right, they should be able to just go in straight here and take down the enemies.
Doesn't drop ZYSF right there despite holding onto the Uber charge. We've got Sticky Traps out front. Uber, of course, gonna get popped straight away. His jump gets negated by those Sticky Traps. Caramel gonna be shiny rushing in, trying to get any picks at all, but it does look like everyone's gonna be able to run back to safety. Caramel running forward, trying to get the pick down onto Thermo. Is just gonna fight each other down. Asuna and Thermo are gonna be finished off. And they're gonna be picking up even more players for the side of the Six Gents. Uber popped for the side of Six Gents, but they're not gonna be able to do anything with it at all. They're just backing all the way to last. Crybaby gonna face off against Jetty, and nothing is gonna happen after that. Spire goes into the hands of SNR. They're just gonna try, possibly do a dry push. They're just gonna try to come in, spam down that sentry gun maybe. But they're just gonna hang back.
Yeah, they have like almost like 80%, and then Turtle Kicks does go down somewhere.
Oh, wait, what
the heck? No one's stopping the point. Oh my god, that is just so that is just so amateurish. I don't know. Like, Turtle Kicks shouldn't have been out of position there, and you just have scouts running in from the bottom left because the soldier's not watching that area. Just...
Were there no stickies on the point?
I am genuinely not sure. Maybe they thought that the sentry was going to take care of that scout, but obviously not in time.
Oh dear me, but yeah, there we go. First point goes into the hands of SNR after that lengthy game. 9 minutes and 30 seconds approximately. 20 minutes counting down.
Getting a pick of medic again.
Two scouts going absolutely huge for the side of SNR. They're going to chase down Turtle Kicks, trying to get that damage done. We've got the Solly bombing in as well, but he's not going to be able to pick off he does pick off quite a number of people, but Hemstar are going to get traded off as well. But it does look like the Six Gents are going to be backing out. Not too keen on playing heels on the midpoint.
Yeah, it's a bit difficult to contest when you know that your enemy outnumbers you by a significant amount, although D4 does seem like he's gonna get some picks through choke here. So once his team meets up with him, they should definitely be able to go in, maybe even contest the point. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the scouts for the side of Signature are just gonna run away. Jetty getting saved by the bell! There's a soldier behind DYSF attempting to make a play for his team.
Turtle!
He does pick Turtle Kicks! What the heck? How did he even get that far behind? Wasn't he a spawner?
No idea where he came from. He came flying across the map, picking up
again,
the medic.
Teleporters.
Like... Yeah. Teleport strats. Is a no clip on? I don't know. But players are just flying across the map, picking off people they're unaware of. And midpoint in the hands of SNR. We've got Six Gents currently on the back foot trying to push back forward. But at the rate things are going, doesn't look like they're too keen on pushing forward. They just hang way, way far back. I don't know why they're not holding maybe a wee bit closer, at least set up some sticky traps at choke. But I guess they're really paranoid about that Uber charge.
I just... Asuna just craters. He ate two spam rockets and then fell to the floor of his escape plan out. But I just want to say that Snake Water was a great game because both teams seemed to be fairly even, and it was both sides playing well and both sides making generally around the same amount of mistakes. But this game has just been six gents dropping players again and again, being in positions they shouldn't be. Like, they're just not holding together as solidly as Signature right now, or even as well as they were the previous game. So we're just gonna keep seeing the same thing happen. Six Gents look like they're in a good position, but then suddenly, like, someone somewhere dies, and then Signature's just gonna walk in and take advantage of the fact that they are one man up, or they have heal at, and this is just gonna keep happening until Six Gents figure out what the heck is going on.
Yeah, I mean, they really need to get their head out of the clouds right now. Both medics do have that Uber charge, and they're just gonna wait and see what they should do. Crybaby just picked up his sentry gun. If it's time to go in, it's time right now. ZYSF trying to spam out that sentry gun, but it's gonna get repaired by Crybaby. So, sentry is still gonna be up in well, level 3, gonna be watching the point as well as the lower side, the lower lobby. The scout gonna get absolutely decimated by the rockets getting tossed out by Asuna, but Asuna gonna get promptly punished for that. Gonna get those scatter shots coming out from Caramel. ZYSF gonna try to spam out that sentry gun, but he's gonna be in range, and he's just gonna be damaged out by the sentry gun itself.
Yeah, it's a stalemate with six gents holding a sentry at the last. Mm-hmm. It's just gonna be, I don't know, one team has to make the mistake or make a great play in order for things to happen. And so far, the only person I've seen who has even attempted to make plays is D4.
Yeah. Thermal ran out into the lower lobby and ran all the way back, somehow surviving. Asuna gonna pick off ZYSF. Does look like they do want to try to push in? Maybe not. I mean, pop the Uber, take down the sentry, and then try to do anything else. That's probably gonna force the Uber coming up from Turtle. Case, we got the Solly coming in, gonna get picked! Gonna pick up Jenny, but Asuna finally gonna get taken down as well. And that is gonna be the scout down. But we've got two players down for the side of the six gents. They still not gonna capitalize on this, I guess.
Well, yeah, it isn't a super great situation to capitalize on. He's getting double donked by Boo. That's something to giggle about. But I gotta say that Asuna is actually doing pretty well here to take heals and get picks down on that main side. You can see him constantly taking 300 and walking into his enemies.
Yeah,
so here you go. He's going in again. The entirety of Signature is actually back out of lobby. I'm not sure why. Supposedly because they don't have a demo. They're going to be backing out to the Spire here and standing on top of it, contesting it. Boo is trying to make space. The Uber has been forced out from the side of Turtle Kicks, but Hamstar is only just now popping it, dancing around. Turtle Kicks is wanting to try and get out here, but the chances are not looking very good for him.
He got out. Why didn't the Sully... No, what? He's going back. What? Okay.
What is happening? Did he walk straight back into the place? Is that what happened?
Yeah. Okay, double dunk coming out. Gonna take down Caramel. ZYSF gonna finally get it picked off as well. We got people standing on the point. The Solly gonna toss out those rockets, but he's gonna take himself down as well. Asuna gonna be the only one up and well, trying to defend the final point against the entirety of SNR. Whipping out the escape plan. That's gonna be it. SNR gonna cap another point. I have no idea what went down.
Six Gents is putting up a pretty disappointing performance here, honestly. Like, they have the potential, like, we've seen them do well in Snake Water. Like, they have the potential to be a well-coordinated team that doesn't, you know, make these kind of dumb Div 3 giving mistakes things on the bobbers. But so far, all we've seen is just them, like, repeatedly walking into things they shouldn't, being in positions they really shouldn't be in, and just dropping players in general.
Yeah, I mean, the fact that ZY could just rush in and pick off so many people, that was just bad on their part. But it does look like they are going to be able to do a pretty successful mid-fight, picking up quite a number of players, but they do drop Turtle during the mid-fight exchange. Hemstar going to make it out alive with a whopping 75% Uber charge. So they're going to have to play really carefully, grab this point, and probably may want to back out to the AOM Spire, or at least hold far away, because SNR, they're probably going to push in once they get through the recharge.
D4 attempted to make a play there just now, but unfortunately that's quite a bit of damage to the medic, but not able to follow up. The rest of Signature's definitely going to try and push in here. In fact, they should be super successful, and the best thing they can do here is to not pop, but unfortunately they have to go straight through an area where they're scared they're gonna be stickies. Jumping in, fairly successful so far. They've done a ton of damage. Two people going down for the side of six gents who are not even close to that Uber charge. If Signature so wishes, they can push in straight here, capping the point off and jumping that soldier through. Like, there's really no one to contest them, but they're choosing not to.
I mean, the Demo Man is just single-handedly spamming out the entirety of SNR. I'm not too sure why they're not jumping over the spam. And there they go, they finally do so. XD still, Meme's gonna jump in, pick off Turtle Kicks, and Crybaby gonna be going down D4 fully shortly after. The only people are gonna be Butt, Asuna, as well as Thermal. Thermal right now gonna be running about, not too sure where he is right now, 10 health. Caramel.
Our DM Jetty there. Ooh. That was quite unfortunate. ZYS are getting a sick air shot into Asuna, but Asuna just follows it up with the Smash Rocket. He's just delaying like time here. He's basically dead. Not doing anything for his team really. And it's Henstar with 100% Uber charge again. Ooh. Yeah, Crybaby is going to build up that sentry and pray that Signature sort of messes up something in the push here. Because honestly, the way things have been going, Signature is just probably going to roll this in and frag all of six gents players. The sentry is going to be destroyed, like, with no consequence whatsoever. I don't know. I'm really hoping six gents just pull together here.
Yeah, they really need to pull together. They're down 2 points right now. We've got 12 minutes on the clock counting down. Does look like they're going to push in with that Uber charge. ZY going to be shiny pushing forward. They need to focus down that medic if they want to do anything. Pyro doing a pretty massive job of just comp blasting everything away. Huge plays coming up from Crybaby. He's eventually going to go down, but the red player is going to be in right now. Solid bomb coming in. Asuna picking off the medic, doing a huge job for his team. Finally going to get picked off as well. Very successful defense coming out from the 6th gen, but we still got the Demo Man in. He's going to be bottling his way, but going to get frying panned into heaven. And a successful defense coming out from the 6th gen. They do have that full Uber charge still.
Yeah,
and,
I get the feeling they're not going to push out here because they're only 3 up and they're not feeling confident about it. So yeah, they're just gonna hold for a bit and then maybe wait for all of their players to come up before they try to walk out.
They're actually pushing out.
Yeah, here you go. Trying to go out through that drop down area. Turtle Kicks does eat a rocket, but they're gonna try and do something. Jetty is in at last, but they have two people watching last. So they should be fairly confident that they're safe, right?
Yeah, they're gonna have to have a Solly up top on Spire as well as a Scout. Scout gonna try to deny that Solly jumping, but 65 health facing off against a Solly. He backs out in the end. We've got Asuna trying to jump about. Aggressive plays coming in from the Scout, trying to get the pick down onto the medic. He's still up and well jumping about!
Oh my god, ZYSF jumps straight in after the medic, into the medic and just drops him. I was calling the Turtle Picks just had to pop there. He was in a situation where they, like, the enemy was gonna end him if he wasn't aware of his surroundings, and that is exactly what happened. He drops the Uber and now six gents is in a terrible position at last. Yep. With only two players up left to defend the point, the Devil's desperately trying to do all he can, but Boo is not enough to stop the momentum from Signature just rolling it in. Six gents, pull it together, please.
Turtle, the turtle strats are not working. You can't hold on to it and hide in your shell. You have to come out and pop that Uber charge. Oh my goodness, that's just such a huge shame to see 100% charge get just gone despite having that sizable Uber ad.
Yeah, like the thing is, it wouldn't even have been a bad Uber at that point because there were so many people running into him.
Oh my god.
Six gents though, they're coming in. They are very angry, coming in full aggression, just putting a ton of damage out, but now their medic has been picked off. And they're over-aggressing into players who are not really that damaged. Oh, it's D4 gonna come in and try and stop the point. Gets a nice rocket, gonna fight that scout off, but he has to land another sick rocket. Oh my god, that was really close.
Yeah, that was really close coming up from D4. We've got some DM action coming in. Asuna gonna pick off Haze all the way at Spire, but we've got another Solly trying to pick off Asuna as well. It's gonna be some MGE battles on the Spire. And he's gonna have to rocket jump away at 7th health. And does look like midpoint is gonna go up into the hands of SNR. Asuna just trying to run through upper lobby, gonna get destroyed, but XD still memes already behind them. And they're gonna push forward onto the next Spire. We've got equal Ubers this time around though, so it's just gonna be probably another spam fest through the choke right now.
I'm not really sure what 6th gens can do here. Like, the coordination from their team is just falling apart. It's basically Rogue, like Thermal taking that 1v1 on that side. Default's gonna get picked off here if he's not careful as well. Like, things like that just shouldn't be happening. Like, don't take that fight. You're a scout. You have the biggest choice in whether you want to take a fight or not. And if he's just gonna lose it, he might as well just back out.
Yeah, I mean, jumping in for no reason, just for the sake of jumping in, is not really a good idea. Asuna gonna be the first player to be shining. Gets denied with an air pipe coming in. Can he get the force downs in the medic? He does so, but it's gonna be a much better Uber coming out for the side of SMR. We're gonna have the shiny scout rushing forward. Caramel gonna do make short work of Crybaby, but Crybaby's gonna grab that health pack. The pistol fight gonna go down. Gonna see which scout comes out on top. They do part ways in the end. And midpoint still in the hands of SNR with the 6 gens dropping quite a number of players, including the medics. So Uber Ad definitely gonna go into the hands of Mstar.
If I'm right, Turtle Kicks pop first, and you know, 6 gens just really didn't do anything with that Uber. Mstar popped it off later, and eventually it just came down to the fact that, like, Signature just out DMing 6 gens at this point. Like, you see Thermal desperately running in, default on the sniper class. I feel as though this team is basically just given up. They're just trying to slow the game down as much as possible, but at the same time, like, D4, see?
Yeah.
What kind of position is that?
Just getting wiped off the face of the earth. And they've got Sentry up once again. They're going to try to watch the flanks. We've got Asuna moving on to the left side, lower, trying to spam those rockets through. But, you know, they're going to have that Uber charge ready to go right now. They could possibly just push in with this and grab another point. But they're just hanging back, you know, on the upper lobby. Going to slowly start making their way in right now. They're going to start going in with a shiny Caramel and try to take down the Sentry. Going to do so eventually. Haze going to be a little bit low. The other Demoman Bar gonna be really low. Caramel's still up and well with that overheal moving forward, but the six gentlemen are just dropping too many players right now, but everyone for the side of SNR still up and healthy, and there they go. I'm just standing on the point, bringing the score 4-0.
I really just don't have anything to say anymore. What needs to be said has already been said.
Yeah.
Six gents are collapsing at this point. Unless they pull a miracle out of their hats, there's really nothing that they can do here. In fact, it's 6 minutes left. Like, I don't think there's any possible way they're gonna bring it back. So we're probably approaching trash time at this point.
Yeah. So I mean, unless they can pull constant 1.5 minute rushes all the way, it's gonna be really hard for them to come back with you know, from a 4-0. So it's up. On this point, it's either, you know, they hang on and leave it as a 4-0, or they just SNR put them out of their misery. But as you can see, mid-fight, of course, has already been underway. We see the 6th gen dropping quite a number of players. Aggressive on cutting from Asuna, managed to get quite successful picks, though, taking out XD and as well as Mstar. We've got some melee action going on. Haze going to get finished off by D4, and it does look like they will be able to grab, possibly grab this midpoint with the scouts coming in. Can he pick up anyone at all, this scout? And yeah, he's going to get picked up in the end.
I mean, at this point they're just delaying the inevitable, which is respectable. D4, that was actually a pretty good bomb from D4 and Asuna. They were just baiting under the point, and then eventually when Signature let their guard down, they came back in and managed to pick it up.
Mm-hmm. So they do grab this midpoint. It's up to them now if they want to close the gap a little bit, try to make it a 4-1 or possibly even a 4-2. But we're just going to have to see how things play through right now. Midpoint, of course, in the hands of the 6 gents with SNR trying to hold on to Spire. We've got some huge rockets coming out from the players right
there. That was pretty good. Ooh. But unfortunately, he got picked, and at the same time, Turbo got picked somewhere on the flank, so his play just got negated.
We've got D4 a little bit laggy. He's stuttering about on the map. He spots Jetty right there. Jetty just running around onto the midpoint, trying to get some picks off. Turtle Kick going to be standing at 96% with Hemstar at 77. So if they want to gain a point on the scoreboard, they got to start moving fast and capitalize on that Uber Rat. But not really much of an Uber Rat anymore with both medics having that full charge. So they're just going to be hanging back on this midpoint, just going to be spamming all their chokes as well as keeping an eye out on the main choke. The SNR players, they have no rush at all. You know, they're sitting very comfortably at 4-0. If they want, they could just hold their own last, or just hold this choke right here. It's up to the 6 gents to actually do something to gain a point. So right now it's pretty much just a time game, and Uber gets traded. So they're just trading Ubers, dancing about. Asuna's going to get try to get the pick down onto the demo man, but Ubers are going to end, and they're going to be caught out in a very bad place. Turtle Kick going to get picked off. Bug getting taken down. Asuna getting absolutely demolished, as well as D4. The only people up going to be the two scouts trying to play those sneaky strats. Thermo going to get spotted. Crybaby coming in, but he's going to get wiped off as well. It's full wipe for the six gens. SNR just going to grab that midpoint.
Yeah, at this point, the soldiers just have free reign on the point. Like, ZYS, they took the Uber trait through Turtle Kicks, and Asuna took the Uber trait through, and ZYS have actually just walked straight through the choke. Through the enemy demo, who wasn't even watching his stickies, and just fragged him. So, I don't know. There's very little that can be done here. SNR gonna be picking up this Spire, probably gonna push into last real quick. They are already sitting at a 65% on the Uber side. Still means getting picked off somewhere.
Soon I'm gonna try to recapture Spire, but we got the demo man. The demo man right there, Hayes just trying to spam him down. We've got another person jumping up top as well, gonna pick up Asuna. ZY gonna pick him up. Thermo gonna try to come in and pick off the medic, but he gets destroyed as well. They're gonna have that full loop charge ready to go. Only four people up for the side of the six gents, so it's pretty much gonna be a uber push in. And there we go, Caramel just coming in. They don't know that he's coming from behind. Caramel spots the medic. Can he get those meat shots that he needs? He does so. Turtle Kick's going down once again. This is pretty much going to seal the deal for SNR. Going to grab this point unless the six gens can successfully defend this.
They definitely aren't going to be able to do it. It's over for them.
Yeah, Solly just standing on the point. Oh, there you go.
It just devolves so quickly. You could see that, like, six gens just started losing it. Thermal kept getting picked off on the flank for no reason. At the same time when Asuna was like trying to go in and work a pick off. So it really just came down to poor team coordination. Like, I kept seeing the same thing over and over again where Thermal dies on the flank at the same time as Asuna is trying to go in. It just doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I don't know. The six gents, they were just terribly messy on this map. Compared to what we saw on Snake Water, I don't know why, what just clicked and they just, you know, they weren't performing as they were. It does look like the logs are a little bit messed up though.
Oh no, I think it's just one guy.
We're bringing up the Snake Water logs instead though.
I can give you the logs.
Yep, no problem.
It's gotta be said that, again, ZYSF did pretty well during this map, but I wouldn't put it to him, like, I wouldn't say it was just him, like, yeah, smashing the other team. It's, like, six gens have really no one to blame but themselves, yeah, like, mm-hmm. why did they collapse so hard, and, like, you need to be able, as a team, to fix these issues and make sure that you aren't gonna, especially when you're being defeated, you have to just find ways to make...
You got cut off? Hello? Vetia?
Hello?
Yeah, there we go. Hello. Yeah, you were...
Sorry,
no problem. You were saying?
Six gents is a team, you know, mm-hmm. And you could see they were really capable of working together, even if it didn't mean they were going to win. But this was just them losing it after a while. They've got to be able to pull together. Also, I have a scrim and I need to go.
Yeah, all right. Thanks for co-casting, dude. Always a pleasure having you on the panel.
Yeah, it's always great to be here. Thank you so much for having. Unfortunately, the game did devolve pretty quick.
Mm-hmm.
But hopefully the next one, the WeCast, will be...
Oh yeah,
a lot closer.
Hopefully. So yeah, thanks for hopping on. I know you have to rush off, so no worries. I'll handle the closings. Before you go, do you have any quick shoutouts that you want to do before you go off?
Shoutouts to my team who are currently participating in Division 1 this season.
Oh,
hopefully we do
yeah.
well together.
Looking forward to all your matches coming forward. So yeah, I've got the logs currently on the screen right now. Top damager is going to be a ZY at 8,900. Once again, Asuna falling behind at 7,500. So definitely, you know, it's the same two guys up top once again, and Haze gonna be falling behind at 7.2, and D4 at 7.1. In terms of the heal spread, you see right now, it's a fairly, pretty much the same spread right there. We've got the Solly, the Demo, the Scout Solly, and Scout. We're gonna have both mechs dropping one time each, with Hamstar getting more Ubers this time around, 10 compared to Turtle Kick 7. Yeah, in terms of medic survivability, I do believe Hamstar was, of course, alive more often. And as we can go through the deaths, we can see a random pyro right there who wasn't even part of the game, but Lol's got a little bit messed up. Haze with only 7 deaths, with a poor friend Asuna at 23. Top KD, of course, going to be Haze at 3.6, so that's a pretty nice KD you got right there. I would say, compared to the previous map, a huge shame. I really, they were generally that they were just performing worse compared to the previous map. You know, 4-2 against, compared to Badlands 5-0, yeah, that's a pretty bad, I don't know, I really don't know what went down, what happened for them. So the winner, of course, was SNR. They're going to be grabbing both maps tonight, 4-2 for Snakewater, as well as 5-0 for CP Badlands. So thanks, that's pretty much going to be it for tonight. I really don't know. Just a huge bummer, that things turned out the way they did, with the six gents just underperforming on the second map. So that's gonna be it for tonight. I don't think we're gonna do any casts later on. Probably not. There is gonna be another cast being covered by Capping TV later on at about 11:30 PM, I believe. So feel free to head on over to that side. Not too sure which match they're gonna be covering. I think it's possibly a Div 1 match. Either Div 1 or 2, I'm not too sure, but that's going to be happening later on in the night, so look forward to that. Of course, always nice to have more AFC action going down. Congratulations, of course, to have the winner of the betting going on earlier, Coronas, winning a huge amount of points right there, so congratulations. Of course, congratulations to SNR for taking both maps, and cheers to everyone who is currently inside Twitch chat. Thank you so much for hanging out, watching our little league going on. Shoutouts to my co-caster Vetia as well. Shoutout to all the people currently inside Twitch chat, and of course, shoutout to the two teams that have been playing tonight, Div 3 6 Gents as well as SNR. Looking forward to all the future matches coming up from these two teams. Wishing them all the best in their later matches. And yeah, that's probably going to be it for tonight. Thank you all for hanging out, and good night.